is up, Marvel fans? Jay Shrey Way here, and I'm finally talking Multiverse of Madness. Doctor Strange Multiverse of Madness, that is, because we need to start putting respect on that man's name. Benedict Cumberbatch's Doctor Strange is a dream cast, and we don't really acknowledge that enough. He's one of those characters where he's a protector, and he's kind of makes the audience feel comfortable, and the characters feel more comfortable, and he's always saves the day. And I feel like we just overlook him as an actor because he buys into the role so much that you almost don't distinguish the two. And I think after this movie, people are really going to start recognizing him more. I've always loved the character since Infinity War, at least. I thought his first movie was a little stereotypical, but after Infinity War, he's just elevated every time. And him and the rest of the sorcerers always feel like they're in on a joke that we don't know about. It feels like they just know more than us. There's always something racing through their mind. There's some hard decisions they're trying to make that we as regular old beings cannot handle. Even with No Way Home, that was a big story beat for Doctor Strange, was putting him in this tricky situation. And that was the last time we saw him. Going into this one, it doesn't pick up too much from Spider-Man or what happened in that, which is kind of weird in my opinion, after a big rift in the sky. But it does springboard right off of WandaVision. And everybody's going to be talking about Scarlet Witch, dude. Elizabeth Olsen's range at this point in the MCU is amazing. And I'm not going to dig too deep into her. You guys can probably guess some things that are going to happen with the character. But you really have to see it to believe it. And it's pretty shocking to witness what she does and other characters do. I was really shocked with the decisions they made in this movie. And by the end of it, I appreciate it. I like risky storytelling, especially with stuff that we can kind of predict. I don't think a lot of this movie was predictable. From the start to the middle to the third act, it all felt like three different things. And it still culminated in a very good way, in my opinion. I think there are some nitpicks to be had. There's not a lot of time to breathe between sequence to sequence to sequence. But all in all, the whole movie feels like one giant sequence. Because it kind of is, once you really break it down and think about the journey you just went on. And that's what's so fun about it. The pacing is amazing. There's not a lot of downtime. There's not a lot of checkout moments. You're going to be locked in the whole time. Especially from the point of the Kamar-Taj scene on, I had to pee at that point and I could not get up. And that's like 30 minutes into the movie. And I stayed the whole rest. I could not get up. I was locked in. There was no moment I found an escape because the movie and the characters had me under their spell. It was gripping. I think Strange was great. Scarlet Witch was great. Wong was fucking extreme. We really get to see how he's kind of the leader now. And they show us a little bit of visuals of that. And show us the whole clan of sorcerers. And show you just the power he has. And it was really enjoyable to see. And just how motivated him and Strange are to being loyal to the sacred spells. And just not messing with time and reality. And the conflictions they have as characters are great, and
we even get back Rachel McAdams as Christine Palmer, and she's way more interesting this time around. But in a sense, it just shows how emotionally detached we are from Strange, and it feels like she's like contractually obligated to show up. But I'm not mad. It's Rachel McAdams.
And I'm shocked at how much I liked America Chavez. She stood out from her opening scene to her last scene. She was fun. She always made it more interesting. I just feel bad for Strange always having to take care of these teenage characters. And it makes him feel like he's robbed out of an adult life. In this movie, Strange really takes some risks. Some of the decisions he makes are crazy. And it's just fucking fun to watch. It was bananas. The whole movie is just something that felt like a drug. It will make you feel like something was slipped into your popcorn. It was fascinating. Yes, the horror in this movie is very strong. It is strong with this one, and it's going to make this movie very rewatchable. It's going to make it fun to go back to it. It's going to make it stand out. This is the most different I've seen Marvel probably ever do in the MCU standard. And even Sam Raimi's directing in the old Spider-Man movies with Tobey Maguire, it's similar to those, but it's not as similar as I was expecting. It's definitely more Evil Dead. And I never was too huge on those movies. I liked the first Evil Dead, but I kept thinking, I can't believe this is the MCU. It could have passed maybe in the 2000s superhero era with Ghost Rider and stuff like that, but by today's standard, this was a big risk. They hit a home run, in my opinion, though. I think the conclusion, it was a little anticlimactic. I think by the end of the day, we had always been looking for that next Endgame. And this isn't it. You get the cameos. Some of it's marketed. I'm not going to talk about them in case you haven't seen them. But the movie doesn't rely on that. The movie really is a solo outing. It's about spellbounding powers and family in a way, and mourning, and it really homes in on the things that you've been waiting to see, but there's still some things that are left unanswered. I will say it does springboard off of WandaVision, but there's other shows that we've been expecting closure to, and other movies that are still up in the air. And it really doesn't open up the universe like you were expecting. It felt grand, it felt awesome, but it felt more like a personal conflict between a few characters more than the stakes of the entire world. And the Marvel Universe keeps going that in a way, even with Moon Knight recently. And every time we get to that final battle, it doesn't feel that grand. Even No Way Home with the cube that Goblin blew up and opened up the rifts. Nothing ever feels that grand. And this one, again, felt like a side mission. And it's leading into another thing. Personally, I didn't like the after credits scenes. I didn't think they were, I think they kind of are losing their momentum. The ones in Eternals were really fire, but this one, yeah, they're kind of forgettable. It was kind of an airball in my opinion. They're trying to shoot for something, and I was like, half the people really don't know what this one is. Sometimes we usually have to Google it. Everybody's probably gonna have to Google what the hell this one meant. But all in all, I love the direction Marvel's going, genre bending, every other movie. I'm glad we finally got horror in the MCU. I'm glad Doctor Strange had such a great display of his powers, and Wong was really not short-ended. I thought he was going to kind of be background again, and they do have him sidelined a little bit in the story, but at the end of the day, it definitely had a good brotherhood between Wong and Strange, and all the other characters you're expecting to see are handled pretty well. Some of them fell a little flat to me. There's definitely some cameos that I was wanting that I didn't get. And some of the cameos we did get, I thought were a little odd. And they weren't as epic as you had hoped. But it's still awesome that they shot for it. But I will say, the big one in the trailer that they teased, the way that one came, that was amazing. I am thankful that that exists in the canon of the MCU now. That character, the way they handled him is what I'll say, was awesome. And it was really trippy to hear some of the conversations and some of the words coming out of his mouth. But all in all, I'd probably give this one 4 out of a possible 5 Goldblums. This is a fantastic outing for Marvel. It's just not as grand as the marketing has led us to believe, some of the previous projects have led us to believe, and the fan base. We're expecting things, and we get some greatness, and we should be happy about it. All I can say is the way they handled Wanda was amazing, and I'd waited to see that since the introduction of the character. That's my closing comments. This is the best version of the character that I could have wished for, and I'm happy they did it. And I don't think everybody's going to come back saying that by the end, but as a fan of classic X-Men, this was a chef's kiss for me, and I think she stole the show. So yeah, thank you for tuning in to the Jay Schrae Way, you guys. This movie is one I'm going to be thinking about and talking about for a while, and now we're on the road in the journey to Thor Love and Thunder. I'm going to still sit and process this movie for a while, and I want to appreciate it, but that's the way Marvel has engineered us, is we got to look forward to the next thing, and this movie definitely promotes the next things. So, yeah, thanks for coming by, y'all. I'll see you in the next one.